Hey guys, it's Artcast number 301. Today I'm drawing Scully and Mulder from the X-Files. I'm doing the old or the young version of them. I'm not quite used to the older version yet, but I am liking the show. So I had a question today. I thought I'd run through it real quick. Somebody asked about my supplies, you know, like my tools, what I use, what I draw with, all that kind of good stuff. I think the question kind of pertained to my painting, which I haven't done a painting video for a while, and I probably won't do one for at least a few weeks, but I'm just going to run through kind of everything I use. I guess first off, the gray paper I use is, it's called, let's see, this Canson My Tintas is what it's called. It's this stuff right here. You guys can read that. Let's see if it'll focus up. And I use the steel gray, and I like it. It's interesting. It's actually a tougher paper to draw on than what I like, I guess. I don't think I could have drew on it when I was younger, because it doesn't take a lot of erasing. It kind of will tear up when you erase on it a lot, all that kind of stuff. So it's sort of an acquired taste, but I like the color of it, I guess. It's got a nice texture that it gives to the drawing, so that's why I keep using it, even though it gets frustrating at times. The color pencils I use are Faber-Castell. These are the black ones. That's what I draw with, usually. Sometimes I'll use Prismacolors if I don't have these. The white ones I use are... Well, this has got some tape on it, but this is a Prismacolor pencil, just the soft kind. I like those because it... You know, it gives it a good white. You know, they're soft enough to lay down quite a bit of color. I don't actually like the Faber-Castell whites because they're very smeary. The Faber-Castells are an oil-based colored pencil, so you can smear it with your finger and stuff, and I like that. But I don't like it with the white. I don't like the whites to smear, so I stay away from the white Faber-Castell. And I also, when I paint, I usually don't use the Faber-Castell colored pencils either. I don't like the way they blend. So I don't use them when I paint. With these kind of drawings, sometimes I'll paint a little bit of white in the very highlights. And for that, I just use the golden acrylic, you know, cheapo white acrylic paint, which works pretty well. Okay, so as far as paintings go, I have a piece of board that I use. I usually use an eighth inch or quarter inch MDF. That's my favorite kind of surface to paint on. Some people call it, like, you know, hardboard, or it's a little different than masonite. I will gesso it. This one's actually raw, but a lot of times I'll throw on a coat of gesso before I paint. But I have painted on it when it's raw, and I like that too. But pick it up at like hardware stores like Home Depot and places like that. Everybody's got it. As far as my paints, like I said, I use the golden acrylic paints, and I also use these ones, the Liquitex Basics. The goldens, I like the colors a little better. The Liquitex paints, I think their colors they're a little bit tougher to find, like the ones I want. I don't like the burnt sienna in the Liquitex, and I don't actually like their yellows either. So. But other than that, like as far as blacks, reds, blues, I can get along with pretty well. But if I could just paint with one paint, I would stick with the goldens. I think they're great acrylic paints. Let's see, so I may as well talk about my airbrush for a second. Here's my airbrush. It's very well used. Beat to hell, but it works good for me. And it's a Badger. I'm not sure what model this is. You could look on the internet and find the one that looks like it. But it's just kind of a Badger single action. I don't do the double action thing. I prefer the single action because it's easier to keep clean. So the adjustment, you know, is up here instead of in the trigger. And as you can see, I got the cup just taped on with black tape. That's so I can actually clean the cup and clean that tube out real easy, and then I just tape it all back together after I'm done. And I get along real well with this sucker. I love this airbrush. But, you know, if you're a guy who just airbrushes strictly to, you know, to airbrush, I mean, I use it in a little bit different way. You might not like it, but I do. As far as the color pencils I use three kinds. I use, like this one here, is Prismacolor. And I use that for the soft, and I want that soft color, because Prismacolors are very soft, and they're very crumbly, and they like to break, but they put down a nice, vibrant color, and that's why I like them. I also use these ones, and these are very hard. You can sharpen them up to a real fine tip, and they'll hold it, and they're called Stanford Color Erase ones, and they have this little goofy eraser. That's how you knew those. And these are great for just fine detail and when you want a hard color pencil, and I use these a lot too, but not for laying down color. This is more kind of for just, you know, putting in detail and stuff. Sometimes you'll come across these and they'll be called Verathin, and that's kind of very similar. And the third kind of color pencil I use is these Derwent color pencils. And these are great. I think these are probably, in my opinion, my favorite kind of color pencil. Because they're the perfect mix between those really hard color erase pencils and the Prismacolors. They're harder, but they're not as hard as the color erase. So they can hold a good tip, you can get good color. But sometimes you can't quite get the vibrant color that the Prismacolors will give you. So the guy who asked the question, he also wanted to know a specific question of a piece that I did. He's talking about, well, let me just read it. I wonder if in your Hulk video you were using acrylic paint or ink when putting in the highlights. So I wanted to make sure I answered that specific question. So I don't really ever use any inks or anything like that, so it was acrylic paint. Anyway, I just wanted to put all that info out there. I hope that answers your question, and thanks for watching the video, guys. I think we have, what do we got? We probably have 3 days left on my Kickstarter, which is funded, but, you know, if you still want to get the book, head on over. The link's somewhere in the description, or maybe it'll be on this video. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.